हाँ
क्वेश्चन,
हाँ
इज देयर अ स्पिरिट बॉडी विच इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम व्हाट वी अंडरस्टैंड एज जीवात्मा, बिकॉज जीवात्मा इज इटसेल्फ इज अनरियल, राइट?
ओके, व्हाट यू हैव आस्क्ड मी इज अ क्वेश्चन व्हिच आई विल जस्ट गिव यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग फ्रॉम द पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ इंग्लिश वर्ड्स एंड आवर मेथड्स ऑफ एक्सप्लेनेशन. ओके, फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट, दिस इज कॉल्ड अ फिजिकल बॉडी. ऑल राइट, दिस इज द फूड बॉडी. वी ईट एंड दिस बॉडी कम्स इनटू एग्जिस्टेंस. खाया पिया सब लग गया, या कभी कभी नहीं लगता. हाँ, राज ने खाया तो उसको बेचारी को कुछ लगता ही नहीं है, वो है वो ऐसी है पतली. लेकिन मेरा तो स्टमक भर जाता है. तो जो खाया पिया वो बॉडी में आ गया, दिस वन फिजिकल बॉडी. सेकेंड बॉडी, थर्ड बॉडी, देर आर बैलेंस नंबर ऑफ बॉडीज दैट आर देयर. दे आर ऑल माइंड, इंटेलेक्ट एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फॉर्थ. दीज आर बॉडीज कनेक्टेड टू द फिजिकल ओनली. इट्स लाइक द रशियन डॉल्स, यू नो, वन इनसाइड द अदर, इनसाइड द अदर, इनसाइड द अदर, इनसाइड द अदर. देर आर फाइव डॉल्स टूगेदर. ओके, दीज फाइव डॉल्स, दे आर लाइक अ फ्रूट, वन फ्रूट. ओके, इट इज हैंगिंग ऑन अ ट्री. ऑल राइट, it is hanging on a tree. The tree is connected from the roots, it grows up, and then there is a branch, and from the branch it is hanging. Correct?
Okay.
Now, all the nutrients in the ground, are they not coming up to the fruit?
Yes.
Correct? So everything is coming to the fruit, and this fruit is alive.
Yes.
So this body is alive because of the things which are coming over there. That which keeps this fruit alive, is called the spirit.
It's common.
It is keeping it alive. Even the leaf of a tree is there, isn't it? The leaf is alive till it is connected to the tree.
Connected to the tree.
Correct. So that is called these two things. This is what you got to understand. This is called Kshetra and Kshetragnya. The leaf or the fruit is the Kshetra.
Kshetra.
The one which is keeping it dynamic and active and alive is called the Kshetragnya. Got it? Right?
Yes.
So that is called the spirit which is keeping this body alive. Now, the spirit is that which is keeping even the tree alive. Remember, the whole tree is, the tree starts from the root, isn't it? The root is also alive, correct? But if I cut the root, what happens? The tree is dead. You got the point or no? So the tree is not only the fruit or the leaf, it is also the roots, the stem, the branches, everything connected to it, the flowers, the fruits, everything connected to it. Got it? So the whole tree is dynamic and alive just because of the base, which is called the ground. The ground on which the tree is stuck, isn't it? So we, human beings, we are stuck in this ground which is called the spirit. The spirit is all around us. It is alive and keeping this fruit alive. Alright? Now, when the fruit is ripe, what happens? It falls down. Or in autumn, the leaves fall down, correct? They become yellow and they fall off. Same way, all these fruits, the leaf and all fall down. When they fall down, is it connected to the body anywhere, to the tree?
No.
No. So the spirit disconnects. But if it disconnects and the fruit has fallen down. So when the spirit leaves the body dies. Got it? This much understood?
Yeah.
Now, the most important point is coming just now. The spirit is disconnected, the body falls down on the ground and dies. What happens to that fruit or the body? It goes back into the soil. Isn't it? Everything gets dissolved into the soil. So, we call this as Prakriti. Prakriti is nature. everything, all elements go back into the nature. Got it? Now, that which is running this whole system together, that means the spirit and this body, something is running both this or no. So it is on some framework. It's on some framework. I can't suddenly have one ground somewhere suspended in animation in space like that and having some fruits coming out of there. Tomorrow I will have, instead of that, you know, after the but Mars, what do we have? Asteroid belt, we'll have all the fruit belt over there. So think about it. So there is something which is holding the whole thing together. This, that means this element called the spirit and this element called the body is being held by something. That something is called the Paramatma, the God. We just call it Paramatma. We call it the divine consciousness. We can call it whatever we want to, Father in heaven, yeah, Allah or God, or I don't know. You can call it by whatever name you want to call it. Alright? So, now how does this work in the beginning? Now we have come up to here from fruit to there. Now I will take you from there to the fruit. This thing which is called a supreme divine consciousness or Krishna or God or Allah or Father in heaven or God knows whatever you want to call him or that only, THAT, because Nisargadat Maharaj calls it that, so we can also call it that. Suppose you want that. Now this that, what it does is it gives a spark like that. And that is the thing which I explained that NMLA, the thing which I told you about the candle thing. It just starts the whole process all over again. Starts. Continues till the end. So finally the whole candle is burnt and it goes away. So the spirit is gone, candle disappears, body is disintegrated into the air, carbon dioxide, hydrogen, I don't know what all it becomes of the candle. Because it's a hydrocarbon at the end of the day. Correct? No. For Rajeshri's purpose, it is hydrocarbon means candle. Okay. When you burn the candle, it becomes hydrogen. Hydrogen oxide, which is nothing but water, drinking water, and carbon dioxide. So both the things. So it becomes both the things. So that is how the whole system works. Just the initial spark is what we need. So Vishnu, so what Padma asked the question, Vishnu was dreaming about this initial spark and he started the process. And the process is like, you know, production ka button on kar diya, dhanadhar, chalu hai production. It's a self-sustaining system. It's a self-sustaining system. Please understand, you know, what is the meaning of self-sustaining system? You see, if you are a farmer, you will understand. You go to the same field, plant rice over there, after some time the whole, you know, wo cut cutne ka, uske baad wo jo baki ka portion hai usko jala ke wapas soil mein dalna, phir wapas next year rain aega, phir wo wapas wo dalne ka seeds, wapas usme se rice aega. It's a self-sustaining system. Can you imagine this? Tuk 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 chalu hai. Alright? So this is how the sustaining system works. So I think I have given you an idea about the soul. The super soul, which is, there is nothing called individual soul, it's only one Paramatma only. Spirit and body. All this system works in one place. Got it? Okay. So where are we supposed to start with? Vito? Raj, where are we?
It's verse 16, sorry, not 16, it's verse
13. Okay, this is Canto 3, Chapter 2. All the demigods from the upper, lower and the middle universe planetary systems assembled at the altar of the Rajasuya sacrifice performed by Maharaj Yudhishthira. After seeing the beautiful bodily features of Lord Krishna, they all contemplated that he was the ultimate dexterous creation of Brahma, the creator of human beings. So, we'll go step by step to the three things. First thing he says, the demigods from the upper, middle and the lower. We have demigods in the three regions. What are these three regions? The upper, highest loka, the middle loka and the lower one. See, there is no mention of what is called as demons over here. Have you seen that? No demons over here. Actually, all the angels become demons only, like in the Bible. Okay. All angels are nothing but demons. Only un log ka mukhavta khali change acha hai. Matlab starting mein wo log hai na hero hai, baad mein jaake villain bante. So it's like the same thing over here. We have gods from different realms. The realms are different from a different perspective. Okay, just one god I will take. One god, okay? You know, he is called by the name Shiva. Have you heard of the word Shiva? Very good. The highest realm is called Shiva. Okay? He is literally like the supreme being. The middle name, Maheshwara. He sustains these things. He is running the whole universe like that. And the bottom realm is called Rudra. Rudra Avatar, we have heard of this, isn't it? Rudra, Rudra means angry form. So we have angry form. Like that we have these three, the same god in three different realms form three different things altogether. In some places, this god is also known by the name of Bhairava. I'm sure you have heard about the name Bhairava. His wife is also called by a similar name, Bhairavi. Dangerous, very dangerous thing. So, they have a domain which they manage. Okay? Now, how many of you have heard about the Silk Road? Okay, good. Hardly few have heard of the Silk Road, huh? So sad. You should read. The person. In San Francisco, there was this dude.
19-year-old.
Yeah, very young man who was staying in a paying guest accommodation together with two of his friends. This dude was running one of the world's biggest crime syndicate.
Cartel.
He had a website, Silk Road, where you could buy literally anything from drugs to anything. Everything was paid by bitcoins. And now don't tell me I have to explain bitcoins to you, okay? Last time I gave a lengthy explanation of bitcoins. Alright? He had accumulated $1.2 billion worth of these bitcoins, which translates into his earnings, which were translated into the more than the GDP of Russia. So, now this is how the whole realms work. On one side we have completely the other aspect of it, and on the other side you have something which is really very dynamic in nature. Very attractive, very nice and good to look at. Yes, Padma has written, so each one of us have all the three, of course we have all the three realms in us. Okay, aapne Mr. India wagera dekha na picture? Haan? Ya phir koi ek achha, jise Shole dekha. Abhi samjho, Shole dekha, matlab main to Baba Adam ki zamane ki baat kar raha hu. Shole, bahut se bachche paida nahi hue honge us time pe. Now when you see Shole, na, at that time you look at Dharmendra and Amitabh Bachchan. In the beginning, इसे hero लोग रखते हैं। फिर उसके बाद आते हैं बसंती कांगे वाली। उसको सब सिर घुमा के रख देती है। और तीसरा आता है गब्बर सिंह। उन्हें the moment गब्बर सिंह और वो सोमवार कितने आदमी थे ऐसा बोला कि है ना अपना हवा निकल जाएगा। So see, in our own being, we have created three entities like that. When we think of Amitabh Bachchan or Dharmendra, we think of, are you Mausi? You know, Marna cancelled, that beautiful dialogue comes into our mind. And we feel like smiling and laughing. Okay? And then Basanti Tangewali is kidnapped. अभी कितना गुस्सा आता है hey, बसंती चंगेवाली को किडनैप किया जब तक है जहाँ जाने जहाँ वो नाचने वाली है बाबा रे बाबा उसका हाथ भी पकड़ के कुछ सो यू फील लिटिल बिट सैड यू नो नाउ एंड देन यू फील लाइक यू नो वो गब्बर सिंह अगर मिल जाए ना मुझे तो बराबर कर दूंगा सो वी हैव दिस थ्री थिंग्स कमिंग इन अस वी वॉन्ट टू द सेम पर्सन यू have got three different kinds of things happening inside of you. So every object can be seen from three different perspectives. Okay, Raj, you don't know Shole, so I will tell you about Shivaji.
Shivaji. Chennai Express.
Okay, otherwise Chennai Express, I guess.
What makes you think that I don't know Shole?
Oh, I thought so. Okay, let us say Chennai Express. Shah Rukh Khan. Very good. Man. Okay. And the middle fellow is what? The middle chapter is Deepika Padukone. And the last one is Tangavali. Tangavali, the other. So, these are the emotions which we come under and they are dominated by means of different realms. We can swing from this to this. So, the demigods, these are the gods which rule these kingdoms. Various kingdoms are ruled by various demigods. So upper, lower and middle planetary systems assemble at the altar of the Rajasuya sacrifice. Rajasuya sacrifice, if you know, is a sacrifice done for the king who is crowned himself the king, the super king. And what he does is he sends his horses so that somebody catches it and performed by Maharaj Yudhishthira, and after seeing the beautiful body, at that point in time, Krishna had also come. See, Yudhishthira has invited Krishna at that place, and naturally Krishna is not a person who has got that car from Back to the Future. So he is not coming in a magic vessel. So he is coming walking only, or maybe he is coming by his horses. It doesn't seem like he is some great person. He takes the regular flights. Okay? He walks from the airport. He catches the airport taxi and he comes. That is a joke, Raj. You need to smile like this. So, when Krishna arrives like this, can anybody think it is Krishna? Nobody can think it is Krishna. Except that he looks more or less like, oh, he looks like Salman Khan, you know? Somebody was telling me, Brito was telling me that Salman Khan has gone and liked Mythistical. Badri, who is this person? Salman Khan has gone and liked Mythistical. Then I saw that one of your friends has liked it. He looks like Salman Khan. So Krishna is walking in the assembly. He looks like a handsome dude. All the girls are falling all over him, you know that. Just like that. So naturally what happens is, they all contemplated, everybody in this assembly is contemplating that this ultimate dexterous creation of Brahma, you know, many a times you say, na, when God was making me, he was fast asleep, that's why I turned out like this. Or when there is a very beautiful girl, how do they say? Kaunsi chakki ka aata and all those things, everything is said, no? So like that, when Krishna is walking in the assembly, everybody says, oh.
Purshat se banaya hoga. Purshat se banaya hoga.
So Krishna ko dekhte hai na, wo kya mast hai, chikna hai, handsome hai, dude hai, cool dude hai. So he's walking. They say, Brahmaji's creation is so nice. Krishna is Brahmaji's creation. Nobody knows. So this is the verse which explains what is happening. The damsels are Raja. After pastimes of laughter, humor and exchange of glances were anguished when Krishna left them. They used to follow him with their eyes and thus they sat down with the stunned intelligence and could not finish their household duties. He was so enchanting, enticing, and he used to make everybody go mad. So an example is given of those gopis of the Vraja. Vrajabhumi. Vrajabhumi is where Krishna comes from actually. Golok Vrindavana as they say. So all the gopis are satkela unka. Sab gaya hai. Upar kuch bachta nahi hai. Charana bhi nahi hai. Krishna ko dekhne ke baad hai na sab. You know, like they, that day I was watching this movie of Ranbir Kapoor. Ye Jawani Hai Diwani. You know? So when he comes on stage, everybody goes, like that, you know. So imagine he's walking and all the gopis over there are going, like that. They go mad with delight. They can see a very beautiful person in front of them. It is actually not a persona that they are attracted to. Every being, sentient, this is for you. Every being is attracted towards the Supreme Divine Consciousness. If it is not attracted, no, your body mein koi jaan nahi rahe. Correct? Got the understanding? So this body, to have its life, we need to be attracted towards the Supreme Divine Consciousness. That means this Father in Heaven, this consciousness gives us the light, which is on this theme. And then every body, which is a gopi, is dancing to its tunes, is madly in love with it. So we all love our life. Okay? You know, kisi ke samne aisa chura karenge na ya fir banduk aisa rakhenge to, or he is afraid of his life, you know that? He wants to live. How much he wants to live? Think about it. There is a video which is there in circulation on Reddit. If you go to see, this woman, I mean, is there even in one of the newspapers. This woman got inside this godown, poured kerosene on petrol on herself and lit herself. And she is desperately trying to run around here and there, trying to save herself. Okay, you know, the person goes in absolute desperation to live. Everybody wants to live. Why do they want to live? Because the love that we have for the divine consciousness, the one inner being, which is what we call as a spirit, is the highest. We love ourselves the most, you know that, no? I told you all the story of that monkey and the monkey's baby. The monkey finally puts the baby under its feet and climbs on top. At the end of the day, we love and value our life more. So in the same way, the Vrajabhumi's gopis are nothing but we ourselves. We are in love with this Supreme Divine Consciousness, as we call this dark god called Krishna. Dark because we don't know who he is, by the way. Kaun hai wo? Pata nahi kaun hai. So like that, you know, kaun hai wo? The personality of Godhead, the all-compassionate controller of both the spiritual and the material creations, is unborn. But when there is a friction between his peaceful devotees and a person who are in the material modes of nature, he takes birth just like fire accompanied by the Mahat Tattva. When there is a friction, you see, he is always a very benevolent person. He is called the Supreme Divine Consciousness. He does not need to come back to this earth. But when something is going wrong somewhere, he needs to come and take birth. Alright? If you see his entire life, whether it is Sri Ram or Sri Krishna or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or whatever, in every life of his, he has to come with his team. So he comes with his team. Because support functions are important, isn't it? You can't have just one Ram, isn't it? You need to have all those Vanar Sena within, all the monkey people. Similarly, when Krishna is there, he has all his gopis and his Yaduvamsh. Everybody is there with him. So this is what happens to the person. Everybody comes like in the team with him. So he takes birth just like fire, accompanied by the Mahat Tattva. The accompaniment is also there. That which burns this whole universe. So when he comes with his entire creative team. Pura hila ke chhod denge, aisa. You know that? So this is the essence of it. So if there is any friction between his peaceful devotees and a person from the modes of the material nature. Let's say, for example, what is being contemplated as of now. Today, the world is suppressed by all these people out there. So he has to take a birth, which is in the form of a body. He has to take a body, he has to accept a body. And when he accepts a body, the entire fire ring around him is also created. And then he takes birth. Got it? When I think of Lord Krishna, how he was born in the prison house of Vasudeva, although he is unborn, how he went away from his father's protection to Vraja and lived there incognito out of fear of the enemy, and how, although unlimitedly powerful, he fled from Mathura in fear, and all these bewildering incidents give me distress. This is what we call is he's going to enactment is this. He is born. Like he has to accept a body. Please understand, the divine consciousness takes a body. He comes in the form of a very simple baby. And the baby is in a jail. Think about it. If the baby is in a jail, or is in a devil there was, usko crib mein ho gaya na. Beto, you have to supply the word, boss. Where was he born?
Manger.
In the manger. Yeah, one is in danger, other one is in manger. No. So, aisa karke uska paidaish hota hai. So, he is born like this. Incognito, nobody knows, you know, the baby is born and is. After that, what all he does? Allah gulla? Nobody understands. Because everybody is covered, if you remember the first line we started, Maya Devi. Okay, Yoga Maya is the one who is covering everything up. She doesn't allow anything to be seen. So here also he says, he was born in the prison house. And then he went under his father's protection. Imagine he is going like a baby and he is saying, Daddy, Daddy, I want an iPad, you know. Hello. I am thinking in terms of a modern Krishna. In ancient times, he would have said, you know, Daddy, Daddy, give me a glass of milk or something. Okay, abhi wo kya bolega, you know, lactogen, pata nahi, aise kuch to bhi puchhega. But today, even in today's day when he is born, he is going to be completely incognito. He is going incognito all the time, you know. So, he lived there incognito. Incognito means nobody knows his presence. Nobody understands he is there. He lives in a completely incognito condition, out of fear of enemy, and he behaves exactly like, you know, kisi ne usko aisa, hey, kya kar raha hai? So, you know, he is anyway, this is again Bombay style, but Raj Teri ko bol raha hu main. But tang bol hi karke aaya koi to bhi to hai na darne ka aisa, thoda sa. So he was also very scared of Tangabali, big chaps. And although unlimitedly powerful, though he is very powerful, but he doesn't show he is having any powers at all. He is behaving completely like a person who is absolutely no power. And then he fled from Mathura in fear. His greatest enemy was there, who? Shishupal. Right? And the father-in-law of Kamsa. He got very scared of them. And he ran away from Mathura to Dwarka. Think about it. Why will a God want to run from one place to the other? Just like Jesus Christ. You see, all these people in the church, they used to say, you know, you cannot practice this type of thing. So one fine day, Jesus Christ disappeared. For 14 years he went and did his search. In the same way, Krishna behaves completely like this. There is no way of knowing where he is going. So all these are bewildering incidents. Bewildering incidents mean they are very, very, oh my God, is this what God is all about? He darte rehta hai sabse. Aisa kaisa aadmi hai? Like that, you keep on thinking like that. Lord Krishna begged pardon from his parents for their inability to serve their feet due to being away from home because of the great fear of Kamsa. He said, oh mother, father, please excuse us for this inability. All this behavior of the Lord gives me pain at heart. You know, if you ask a normal human being to say sorry, why is that? Have you seen? Sorry, bol. Sorry. He is really not sorry. But have you ever heard Krishna say sorry? He will say sorry from the bottom of his heart and he will say, I'm so sorry, please excuse me, pardon me, ye wo, pura acting ke saath pura wo tumko pehnaega. So he, like that he says sorry to his parents also. I'm very sorry, you know, when everything was going wrong, Kamsa was there, I was afraid of him, that is why I ran away. So he is telling them sorry. Even this is bewildering. Why would a God say sorry to people, of all the people in the world, why does he have to say sorry to his parents? Think about it. To his friends too, he said sorry 100 times, you know. But to his parents also, he keeps on saying sorry. So he says sorry like that. All this behavior of the Lord gives me pain. Imagine, if you hear, now think about it, you know, if there are two friends are going out and something happens and this friend of yours says sorry. How do you feel when the person is saying sorry? Why would he say sorry? Zaruri hai kya? Tune to kuch galat kiya nahi. You have not done anything wrong. Why are you saying sorry? So in the same way, this person is saying the same thing. Why does Krishna have to say sorry? Whereas you know that he has not done anything wrong yet, he is asking for pardon. Who, after smelling the dust of his lotus feet, even once, would ever forget it? Simply by expanding the leaves of his eyebrows, Krishna has given the death blow to those who are burdening the earth. When he raises his eyebrows even a little bit, no? So, he has done these various leelas, if you remember, killing KC and all those other demons which are there. We have learnt it when we were children also. Huh? Putana. He drank her milk and she dies. Remember that story? In the same way, he has killed so many of these demons. This Krishna, even if he lifts his finger or his eyebrows, the whole world can shake. Things can happen just by that. We have personally seen how the king of Chedi, that is Shishupala, achieved success in yoga practices, although he hated Lord Krishna. Even the actual yogis aspire after such success with great interest by performance of their various practices. Who can tolerate separation from him? Shishupal is one of his greatest enemies. Shishupal is the original form of Ravana. You know Ravana? And the previous form of Hiranyakashyap. You know Hiranyakashyap also? Yes. So Hiranyakashyap, Ravana and now Shishupal. The same role. Shishupal has been given, like Ravana if you remember, was given the golden kingdom of Lanka. He was made the powerful king of Lanka. You know? In the same way, Hiranyakashyap was made the king of the demons. Correct? He was given all the goods that are required to make him strong. Same way Shishupal was a very, very strong king. He was given all the yogic powers. What does Krishna do, you know? Krishna bestows on his greatest enemies all the fantastic powers that are needed. You think about it. If Krishna is giving you something out of the extraordinary, then think you must be his biggest enemy.
So the ego rises.
The reason why Krishna gives this is so that the ego rises. The more the ego, the higher the person climbs. And the higher the person climbs, aisa karega to gir jayega, tab karega, upar se. So the fall is the greatest of the fall. So Krishna always gives the maximum to those whom he never likes or those who are his greatest enemies. Got it? So this verse will tell you that Shishupal was given all the yogic powers that were necessary because of this. Certainly others who were fighters in the battlefield of Kurukshetra were purified by the onslaught of Arjuna's arrows. And while seeing the lotus-like face of Krishna, so pleasing to the eyes, they achieved the abode of the Lord. Even when you observe the face of Krishna, while you are dying, do you know when a person dies, he is told to take the Lord's name? Just the name, the remembrance of the name. Say Ram, say Ram, say Ram, something like that, you know, Ram, Ram, Satya hai. Wo bhi bolte. And Gandhiji, when he died, he said, hey Ram. Isn't it? So, you said something, Krishna and enemy doesn't gel. How can Krishna have enemies? No, no, these are his doorkeepers. You know the doorkeepers? Right? So the doorkeepers have become Hiranyakashyap, have become Ravana, and have now become Shishupal. And it is the curse of these. If you remember, Brahmaji's children had come over there, four of them, and they had cursed these two guys. Okay? So these are the same people. They are basically not enemies as such. All this is called Leela. So, certainly others who are fighters in the battlefield. So even those who were fighting in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, when they looked at Krishna and died, they reached the heavens. So even in our normal human birth also, we are told very carefully, you please take the name of the Lord and then you die so that you can reach the heavens. So here, just by looking at him, they have reached over there. Lord Sri Krishna is the Lord of all kinds of tree and he is independent, supreme by achievement of all kinds of fortune. He is worshipped by the external, eternal maintainers of the creation, who offer him the paraphernalia of worship by touching their millions of helmets to his feet. He is the supreme lord of all the worlds, all the Aishwaryas in the world. Okay, Aishwaryas means glories, not Aishwarya Rais. The glories of this world, whether it is the name, the fame, you see the name fame is one of the glories, isn't it? Money, fame and fortune is another thing, it's another glorious thing to have. Lordship over people, all these three. What? When you rule a kingdom, very big king you are. You may be the prime minister, president or something like that, you are a very big fellow. The lordship over people, when you have money in your hands, lot of it, and you are very famous. All these things put together. Krishna is beyond all these things, by the way. All kinds of fortunes are coming from him only. He is worshipped by all the other things, external nature, everything is worshipping Krishna in its own way. What is the way of worshipping Krishna? Very simply is to put your head onto his feet. You see, today, nowadays, we don't have caps. In ancient times, they would put a helmet on. Today, when we drive a bike, we have to put a helmet. But in ancient times, when you have to go and fight, you have to put a helmet. So they used to put their helmet on his feet. Today, we can touch the feet with our heads. That is, we are taking obeisance to the Lord, we are paying obeisance to him. We are touching his feet. And then you can be rid of a number of sins. Therefore, O Vidura, does it not pain us, the servitor, when we remember that he, Lord Krishna, used to stand before King Ugrasena, who was sitting on the royal throne, and used to submit explanation before him, saying, "Oh my Lord, please let it be known to you." Who is Ugrasen? How come you all don't know?
Devaki's
grandfather.
Krishna's grandfather.
Yeah, Krishna's grandfather.
Think about it. In Mathura, he, remember, he gave the kingdom to his grandfather. Remember that? Kamsa. He killed Kamsa, became the king, but he handed over the kingdom to his grandfather. Now think about him. He is the Lord Almighty. And yet, he would show respect to his grandfather. He would stand over there, oh mighty great, like that, you know. And this is what he used to say, "Oh my Lord, please let it be known to you." What is protocol? Protocol is the most important thing in this world. By these words you will understand, even God follows protocol. You see, tomorrow if God comes to meet Mr. Obama, he will say, "His Excellency, Mr. President of the United States of America." Oh, aisa karke bolega, sir. Paisa nahi bole, ye kya baat karta hai? He can't say those words. So when he goes to take his Nobel Prize, he has to bow down. And then he has to accept it. You may think that it is a stupid thing to do. No. Protocol is the most important thing in the world. Because even Krishna follows protocol. If you remember, during the war also, he came as an envoy. Isn't it? In one of the episodes, he comes as an envoy. And then he offers peace. Right or wrong? An envoy can never be touched. An ambassador is never touched. He is allowed to go. In the same way, when he made his grandfather the king, he was following protocol. He would sit in the assembly like a normal human being. Even after winning the kingdom over, he never said, "Mera Raja." No, he never shows that who he is. He'll always behave like a common man. He behaves like a person from the roadside. Very common person. So he follows protocol. Alas, how shall I take shelter of one more merciful than he who grants the position of mother to a she-demon, that is Putana, although she was unfaithful and she prepared deadly poison to be sucked from her breast. This I have just explained to you. He gave her the position of a mother. When somebody suckles from the breast of a woman, when Krishna suckled from the breast of this lady called Putana, he gave her the darja deta hai, darja bola jata, the position of a mother. So, human beings need to do this in their world as well. You should respect, yes. So, the respect has to be given. So, Putana has to be respected. And that is the reason why he says, he has given respect to Putana and then he gives her the heavens after she dies. So, never deride a person whose breast you have suckled. Never, never, never in life. If, you know, we consider them as our mothers. Krishna is telling you some very beautiful lessons over here. I consider the demons who are inimical towards the Lord to be more than the devotees, because while fighting with the Lord, absorbed in thought of enmity, they are able to see the Lord carried on the shoulders of Garuda, the son of Praksha, that is Kashyapa, and carrying the wheel weapon in his hand. The wheel weapon in his hand. There is a particular form of a Lord which is called Vishnu. He is always riding atop the Garuda. Now this form is seen by those who are dying. Okay? Now, let me tell you something else. When you see the form of a Yama at the time of death, okay? That is called Yamadut. Please note that you are not going to heaven. तो लिख के रखो मंगता है तो कल यमदूत आया ना तो हेवन नहीं पहुंचने वाले हैं, शिवदूत आया ना तो देन यू नो यू आर गोइंग टू कैलाश. एंड इफ यू गेट टू सी द दूत ऑफ विष्णु देन यू आर गोइंग टू विच प्लेस
वैकुंठ.
राइट, यू आर गोइंग टू वैकुंठ. सो दिस इज हाउ द डिस्क्रिप्शन इज. Imagine when you are dying about it. ऐसा imagine करो हमारे हिंदी फिल्म में बताते ऐसा जाड़ा काला आदमी with one big मुच्छी and one डंडा in hand and one black भैसा with him. Oh my God! By just looking at him, Thangabali and his four goons, I am reminded of those. What? You know the four goons that are there? They look like those. When those goons come to carry you, remember you are going to hell. And if you see some nice homely people, nice smiles and all that, then you know you are going to Vaikuntha. So here he is saying the same thing. So the people who died in the battlefield are those who died because of certain reasons in front of Krishna. They saw a very beautiful form in front of them, which was with the Garuda and this form of Vishnu who carries that weapon in his hand. So they reach his domain. So whichever domain that you get to see, please now know where you are going. And in case if you don't see anything, then you know you are going to the domain of nothing.
Buddha.
You will become nothing. The personality of Godhead, Lord Sri Krishna, being prayed to be by Brahma to bring welfare on the earth, was begotten by Vasudev in the womb of his wife Devaki in the prison of the king of Bhoja. Now the story is there. Thereafter, his father, being afraid of Kamsa, brought him to the cow pastures of Nanda Maharaj, and there he lived for 11 years like a covered flame with his elder brother Baldeva. I think we are first time we are hearing this, that for 11 years Krishna lived in Vrindavana, Gokul. You know that the entire area is called Vrajabhumi. He stayed in the Vrajabhumi for 11 years. Okay? And in 11 years, what all he did, don't ask. What? All gopis, imagine all gopis from, what is, 6 years, 16 years or what? Till 80 years and 90 years. They were all madly in love with him. बेटो जस्टिन बीबर से बहुत हैंडसम था. सो इन हिज चाइल्डहुड द ऑलमाइटी लॉर्ड वाज सराउंडेड बाय काउहर्ड बॉयज एंड काव्स एंड दस ही ट्रैवल्ड ऑन द शोर्स ऑफ यमुना रिवर टू गार्डन्स डेंसली कवर्ड विद ट्रीज एंड फिल्ड विद वाइब्रेशंस ऑफ चिरपिंग बर्ड्स. नाउ ही इज डिस्क्राइबिंग द रजभूमि हाउ इट इज. When the Lord displays his activities just suitable for childhood, he is visible only to the residents of Vrindavana. Sometimes he would cry and sometimes laugh just like a child, and while doing so, he would appear like a lion cub. While herding the very beautiful bulls, the Lord, who was a reservoir of opulence and fortune, used to blow his flute, and thus he enlivened the faithful followers, the cowherd boys. The great wizards who were able to assume any form were engaged by the king of Bhoja, Kamsa, to kill Krishna. But in the course of his pastimes, the Lord killed him as easily as the child breaks the dolls. Now, this story is proceeding in a very, very fast way. He is talking about Krishna being born. Then for 11 years, he lived in the Vrajabhumi. When he was living in the Vrajabhumi, he was behaving exactly like a child. Who is up to 11 years old? How would a child behave? Exactly the way he was behaving. He had all his cowherd boys and friends with him, okay, gopis and gopikas, and he was behaving exactly like one of them. He would take the cows and the bulls all over grazing, bring them back. They saw in him the true Lord, but Please understand, these gopis and the gopikas are coming to him from the same domain. If you remember the domains, the domain of Golok Vrindavana, they were coming from the same domain. They knew who he was. He also knew who they were. But the discussion was never on the planes of, I know who you are. Aisa koi zaruri nahi. They behaved like a very, very normal human beings. The great wizards who were able to assume any form were engaged by King of Bhoja. Now, Kamsa, what he did was, because you see the whole story goes where that Akashvani happens, right? Where he is told that this child over there is going to kill him. So what he does is he keeps on sending his emissaries who want to kill the child. Alright? They are supposed to murder him. They are supposed to kill him. They are supposed to do all sorts of wrong things to him. And that is what, whereas Krishna, if he would have just blown over, he would have killed Kamsa if he wanted to, isn't it? But he was not like that. The inhabitants of Vrindavana were perplexed with the great difficulties because a certain portion of the Yamuna was poisoned by the chief of the reptiles, Kalia. The Lord chastised the snake king within the waters and drove him away. And after coming out of the river, he caused the cow to drink the water and proved that the water was again in the natural state. One of the stories is of Kalia, the demon. Okay? There was a very big fight between Garuda and the demon Kalia in one of the islands which was owned by the great king. Who? The king Neptune. English ne bol raha hu.
Varun Dev.
Varun Dev. So Varun Dev used to own this island, and there the Garuda, he wanted to stay over there. So what he did was, he had a fight with this snake. The snake was very strong and powerful. Finally the snake ran away from there and came into this particular river which is there in Vrindavan, and he stayed over there. And one day the ball of these gopis fell inside the river. And nobody could go inside the river because it was poisonous because of the snake, Kalia. So what he did was, Krishna went inside, fought with the demon Kalia. He was a demon, by the way, in disguise. Bashed him up, stood on top of his head and came out holding the ball and threw it back. And then he told, because Kalia's wife asked pardon from the Lord. And because they asked pardon, he told Kalia to go back to the place where he was, where he came from. So Kalia complained to the Lord and said, you know, dear God, I cannot go back there because Garuda stays over there. So he said, don't worry, Garuda will stay on another island and you can stay on one island. So Kalia's snake stays on this island which is owned by Varun Dev, and Garuda stays on the other island. Alright? If you actually go in today's day and age to that island, you will have to fly that airline called Garuda Airlines. I'm serious. So, the Indonesia, the place inside the sea, which was the kingdom of Garuda. So, even the airline over there is known by the name Garuda. There is a temple over there in Bali, where there is a three-hooded snake over there. It's a formation of a rock from which water comes out. Okay? And it's under a temple called the Tana Lot Temple. If you go to my webpage now, you will see the Tana Lot Temple. The temple is of Varun Dev. Okay? And this snake is staying down there. I know, mythology, but yeah, it's written in this book. So Supreme Lord Krishna desired to utilize the opulent financial strength of Nanda Maharaj by worshipping the cow, and also he wanted to give lesson to Indra, the king of heaven. Thus he advised his father to perform worship of Goa or the pasturing land of the cows with the help of the learned Brahmanas. So what he did was, he said, everybody used to pray to Indradev because of the rains. You see, in India also we do the same. There is one song in the movies, is a Mega Pani De. Mega, I am not calling you, but the name is like Mega Pani De. So like that, we used to pray to God and say to him, you know, please give us water, you know. Nowadays we don't ask for that. Nowadays we say, you know, can we import from China? And bottle water and everything from France, Evian water. What? But in ancient times we used to pray to the gods in heaven, to Indra Dev, so that he would rain down. Krishna came at that time and said, nothing doing, no praying to Indra Dev. And there he made the people, by the way, his father was a very rich man. He had thousands of cows and all that, so he was extremely rich. In today's day and age, you would say that he was having Amul Dairy, something like that. Okay. Yes, Rito, seriously, if you have so many cattle, you can definitely start a dairy farm. So he had a massive dairy farm, by the way. That was his produce, farmers and dairy farmers. So he said, you have got so much of wealth, why we can't pray to the cows and to the land? Because it is giving us food. So Indra Dev becomes very angry. He says, okay, mere se panga mat lena. And so he starts raining down. So when he starts raining down, Krishna, with his little finger, lifts up this mountain called Govardhana. If you ever go to that place, Govardhana, you will see it's quite a big mountain, very difficult to lift with one finger. Yeah, seriously, you try holding even one small rock with your finger, you can't do it. Krishna held the entire mountain on his little finger. Everybody went under it. And it rained for many days. Finally, Indra Deva had to come down and say, who is this great person who is holding up the mountain? And finally, he had to say sorry to him. Don't all these stories sound very funny to you? Think about it. If you really want to know the meaning of this, I will tell you the meaning, and then I think we are coming literally to the end of it. So we will do two more lines and then I will tell you the story. Story of my little finger. Don't show me the little finger, please. That's not. So, was over Vidura, King Indra, his honor having insulted, poured water incessantly on Vrindavana. And thus the inhabitants of Raja, the land of the cows, were greatly distressed. But the compassionate Lord Krishna saved them from the danger with his pastime umbrella, the Govardhan Hill. TH has drawn a very beautiful picture of the Govardhan Hill being carried by Krishna. It's a very beautiful picture. I've always admired it when I go to their house. So, this is what he did. In the third season of the year, the Lord enjoyed as the central beauty of the assembly of women by attracting them with his pleasing songs in the autumn night, brightened by moonshine. Now this part we will take tomorrow, but before that, the end of the story. How Indra and what does that mean? Okay, so this is chapter 2, we are ending, but before we end, I will tell you the story of Indra and what happens. What is Indra? Devendra is what? Indriyoka Raja.
Senses.
Yes, the sensory organ, which is called the mind.
Mind.
God of mind.
Yes, he's a very powerful person. You know how difficult it is to tell the mind to shut up.
Control.
Shh, don't talk. Yes, now. Aisa bolega to mind bolega. You are telling me to shop. Okay, I will keep quiet. You just wait. You go to sleep, and I'll show you what I can do. Mind is like that. You can't stop the mind talking anytime, except like I told you in sleep. You can't talk to the mind in sleep. But the mind is the most dynamic and active Indra Dev. Now here what happens is, every now and then we keep on praying to this mind, isn't it? We believe in our mind so much. I know what I'm supposed to do. Okay. And the mind is always guiding us in every goddamn thing in the world. It's telling, aaj ye khane ka, kal wo karne ka, kal parso udhar jaane ka. Isko, imagine hum log kisi ke shaadi mein gaye, bolne ka, 500 rupaye se zyada nahi dene ka. Hello. Bole 100 rupaye hi tika na, aur 4 jan ka khana ka kya? बहुत हो गया ना, ओल्ड जोक हो गया, नया जोक मारना पड़ेगा। बोला या वो आईनॉक्स विनॉक्स में जाके पिक्चर मत देख, बोला घर में डाउनलोड करो। बोलो तू तो पैसा दे लेकर छोड़ के इधर। तो हम लोग का माइंड है ना, और माइंड कीप्स ऑन शोइंग अस ऑल दिस फनी स्टफ। ओके आई टेल यू समथिंग वेरी फनी विच हैपन टू डेज अगो। ओके आई वेंट टू वन ऑप्टिशियन एंड बिकॉज इट वॉज 2nd of October द ऑप्टिशियन वॉज he said very nicely, you know, sir, I'm very sorry, you know, today my optometrist is not there. Why? Because celebrating Gandhi Jayanti. Bola, mere ko glasses kal mangta hai boss. I went on the first, sorry, second or next day. So I said, I need the glasses very urgently. He said, sir, very sorry, we can't give. So I said, you know what, let us go to the biggest optometrist in town. And we went to the biggest optometrist in town. How much is this? करके है ना उसका है ना वहाँ पे optometrist के पास जाके है ना नंबर निकाला, फिर बोला एक काम करते हैं हम लोग मम्मी को पूछ के आते हैं। वहाँ से नंबर निकाला, इसके पास आया, इसको दिया और इससे ग्लासेस बनवाया। हम लोग का माइंड ऐसा चलता है। Why? Because the biggest that optical people said 3,500 rupees का एक ग्लास एंड द प्लेस वेयर आई गॉट द ग्लासेस वॉज फॉर 1,000 bucks। यू नो आवर माइंड वर्क्स लाइक दिस। आई गिव यू अ वेरी प्रैक्टिकल डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन ऑफ हाउ दिस वर्क्स। आवर माइंड इज ऑलवेज वर्किंग सुपर फास्ट एंड माइंड हैज गॉट वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट थिंग्स व्हिच ड्राइव्स इट। इट इज कॉल्ड ईजीओ, ईगो। इट ड्राइव्स अस, ड्राइव्स अस, ड्राइव्स अस, ड्राइव्स अस। मेरे जैसा कोई इंटेलिजेंट नहीं, मेरे जैसा कोई अच्छा नहीं, मेरे एवरीथिंग इज ड्रिवन बाय दिस माइंड कॉल्ड ईगो। एंड ऑल दीज इयर्स वी हैव बीन लिविंग ऑन दिस ईगो, फेड बाय द ईगो द माइंड ग्रोज 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 बिग। सो व्हाट हैपेंस, कृष्णा द लॉर्ड ऑफ द गोपीज, यू नो ही कम्स ओवर देयर। व्हाट ही डज, ही टेल्स दिस पर्सन, दिस human being, you know what he tells the human being, अब बहुत हो गया mind का सुनना, mind का सुनना बंद करो, you know, do that once and see what happens. Okay, okay, I will give you one example. Think about it, that in the class or in your company, you are supposed to go and praise the biggest enemy of yours in the company. हर बरस में उसने पीबीसी में नेगेटिव रेटिंग दिया है तेरे को, एंड यू आर सपोज टू गो एंड प्रेज हिम एंड थिंक अबाउट इट व्हाट यू आर गोइंग टू डू। यू नो हाउ डिफिकल्ट इट इज टू से दैट दिस इज सच अ गुड पर्सन, ही हैज डन सच नाइस थिंग्स। यू नो आवर माइंड इज टॉकिंग इन द मिडिल, उल्लू का पट्टा, कहां से पैदा हो गया पता नहीं, क्यों आया यहाँ पे कंपनी में। And on top of it, he's very going away and I am supposed to contribute 1,000 bucks to his stupid goal, you know, what happened?
Send off.
Send off party. Sala, mera paisa khata hai, mere ko diya hi nahi paisa. Look, you know, we are like that. So, our mind keeps on chatting all the time. And here, think about it, Krishna is doing exactly that. He is telling you, oh, mind ko side mein rakke, tum hai na, achha baat karo, chalo. It's the most difficult thing in the world to do. And mind keeps on raining, that, it keeps on raining on you. It tells you, what the hell are you doing? It will never allow you to speak nicely. The words may be coming, you know, we would like to thank you for the 10 years of the beautiful service you have done. You know, your background dialogues are going on. Think about it. No. But can you shut your mind and not talk about it? So, the guy means, you see the cows and the bulls and all those things that are there. This is a human nature, is actually a very, very simple nature. We, as kids, were very simple human beings. Do you know that? We were very simple human beings. We would roam around naked all over the place, you know, picking whatever we got from the ground and eating it, and were very simple-minded. we made enemies with our friends, we would dash them up and 2 minutes later we will share something with them. Do you know as a childhood how you were? As a child, think about it. As a child, we have made friends easily. And as we grow older, friends, everybody is our enemy. Nobody is our friend. Okay, if he is giving me good rating, he is a good friend of mine. कल उसने और किसी को प्रमोशन दिया वो सबसे गंदा आदमी हो गया लो सो दिस इज हाउ वी आर सो माइंड इज एग्जैक्टली वर्किंग लाइक दिस माइंड इज इंद्रा गोवर्धन पर्वत इज द ह्यूज रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी दैट वी हैव टू टेक ऑफ पुशिंग द माइंड अवे विद द गुड थॉट्स पुशिंग दिस माइंड अवे विद द गुड थॉट्स इट्स अ कवरिंग ऑन द लिटिल फिंगर यू नो लिटिल फिंगर ऑफ आवर्स. Think about it. We are actually holding an entire mountain on a little finger. On that one finger called goodness. The goodness in us is what can hold the entire mountain up. Every human being, three divisions, remember three gods inside of us. Little finger. The domain. Where you can hold up the entire world and show your greatness to this entire universe.
But that is that sustenance, Vishnu?
No, it is the goodness inside of us. Everybody has the goodness inside of them. Daya, Maya, ये जो हमारे भावना है, ये हमारे उंगलियों में होती है. You know, have you ever seen a God? You know, when he is blessing you, how does he bless? Yes, daya, maya, karuna and all these are there in his fingers. He gives you all these things and with that he is holding up this entire universal, you know, that big mountain and protecting you from the wrath of this Indra. So that little feeling in us can hold up all the evil that is there in the world, all the venom that is there in the world. All the dirt that is being rained onto you. Once you get out of that, then you are a free man. Because please understand, the Krishna in you is actually standing up. He is telling you, see everything with the proper eyes. अच्छी तरह से देखो हर दुनिया को हर चीज को अपनी नजरिए से देखो बहुत अच्छी तरह से देखो. Let never this mind come and talk to you ever again. You know, in our material world, we are always looking at every other person as enemies. The enemy is not outside, it is inside of us. We have all the venom in us. That is why we can look at another person and say all the bad things. But if this mind's venom is removed out in the form of rain, it rained down, throw it out. It will give birth to a new land within us. It gives birth to a new land within us. And we become free from all these evils of this world. So, if you can lift, it's a very great, bahut heavy rehta hai wo. Heavy bolega to? This entire thing to be lifted up is an extremely difficult task for a normal human being. To get out of it is the most difficult task. But if that little Krishna is there, no, inside of us, he can lift this entire thing for us. So that good little voice inside of you can make you shine high above. And this is the story of Govardhan Hill. Alright? So I shall take your leave. You have a very good evening. Have a good day.